Hello, Eriponia, Tiziana here. Link to my Divinian art in the description below and also for my Patreon if you like to do that. Warning, this video will contain pictures from Google that is not mine, so please give respect to the pictures and owners of these pictures and copyrights. Also, it's going to contain my personally opinions about Alicorn OCs, so if you don't like the topic of that, or you don't think it's something for you, click away or else stay. Yeah, here we go. 3, 2, 1. So I don't know if you guys know, but my inspiration for my Alicorn OC is of course Celestia. I remember seeing her for the first time and was like, I want to be like her. I want to, you know, go in her hoofsteps, or how to say that. Not many of you know that I actually started out as a normal earth pony, and then I became a unicorn, and then I became a alicorn. I still don't have the ability to fly yet with my wings, because they are made out of rainbows and not anything that is solid. But I had the, you know, inspiration from when I was very small. I don't know if you know the song Return to Innocence by Enigma, where there's this white horse running. I actually think it's only a unicorn, but when I was smaller, I remember wanting to have both a unicorn and a pegasi. Who didn't want to have that? Of course. So when I saw Celestia, I was like, she is the, you know, the dream of my OC, or how to say that. I know that I couldn't have a replica of Celestia, of course, because we have seen so many replicas out there, and we have seen a lot of Mary Sue's and stuff like that. But I actually feel like they still have a purpose in the community, or how to say that. Because when you make an OC, you put your love and care into it, even though that people don't think that you do. So let's say that you make an OC, but you don't have a backstory, or you don't have a name for him or her or it yet. And I still feel like it's a possibility to work, you know, more with your OC and work more with yourself. If you practice, you know, working with your OC and working with the background story and stuff like that. Now my OC have a very long and weird backstory, but I have posted it here on my YouTube, so you can always go and watch it. I have a small animation clip where I showed in broad details how I became an alicorn, and you know, how I got my wings and magic and stuff like that. But it's a little bit a long story, so I'm not going to get into these details. I'm just going to say that I wanted to welcome all OCs, not just, you know, Earth Pony, Pegasi and Unicorns, but also Alicorns. My purpose with my OC was to welcome all, so they were, you know, welcome into the community. Because I recently, there have always been, you know, a little bit of Alicorn hate, or how to say that. Maybe also some jealousy and stuff like that, because, you know, not, it's of course that not all ponies can be an alicorn. But now I see, if it is in your heart, right, if you are, you know, have it in your heart, you have all of this magic and you have all of this purpose, and you just want to make an alicorn OC, I think that you should do it. I just feel like maybe we could think a little bit more about background stories and a little bit more about, you know, the looks of our OCs. Maybe also something very basic like the name and the cutie mark and stuff like that. Because I have been into a period where I actually changed my cutie mark 3 times. So let's just say it's not only normal ponies that have problems with their cutie marks, or how to say that correctly, but I actually first got my cutie mark very late, the first one, and was thinking long and hard about my cutie marks. Recently, I just became very fond of the last cutie mark that I have now with the love and peace and art. I know that it was supposed to be in God we trust, or how to say that in, or trust instead of art, but I just love art a little bit more, or how to say that, I don't know. I'm not into crosses and stuff like that, but nevertheless, I do feel like I want just to say that we still have a long way to go, I know, and I also have a long way to go with my OC, I'm not done. But coming out and saying that you're hating on, you know, OCs just because they're recolor, or maybe it's because it's an alicorn, it's not fair. I don't feel it's fair because, you know, not all are blessed with the ability to make art, and not all are blessed with the ability to make great names or background stories and other stuff. So I know that you can pay people to do this, but not all are blessed with the economic financial money to do this. So they're stuck with, you know, what the pony generator can do for them, or the 3D pony generator. I will actually recommend that you use that instead. It can give you so much greater detail and choices. And you can also use the 3D maker for animations and stuff like that. But yeah, I haven't figured out quite how yet. Also, I have been into a transformation where I had my evil alicorn overtake for a while. I feel like I'm done with that, because she's not a part of me anymore. I actually accepted her a long time ago. When I was like 18 or something, I accepted, you know, the evil side of my alicorn, or how to say that. And when I was 18, there wasn't, you know, something called My Little Pony Friendship is Magic. There was a show called My Little Pony, but I didn't see that. I first became a brony when the show actually came out. And I will say that I think that I started as an earth pony. But when I saw Celestia the very first time in the very first episode, I decided that I wanted to be an alicorn, or I wanted to excel to that point, or how to say that. I wanted to be also proud in myself, like, you know, Celestia is proud in Twilight. So I was hoping that, you know, my family and friends would be proud of me by choosing, you know, something that represented me, who I am, and what I love to do. So yeah, quite hard actually to explain this to others, that you can't have your OC in peace. There will always be haters, somebody that is jealous, somebody that thinks it's not a good idea to do what you want with your OC, but I just say go for it. And if you don't have the money for it, I will recommend that you link me on my DeviantArt. I will make the first OC for free. I will not say that I will make all of your OC ideas and all of your background stories and stuff like that and names, because I don't have time. But I would really like you to write to me if you want the first OC to be free. And, you know, into the future, I would really like to, you know, get some payment for making OCs. Now, I'm using bases and stuff like that, but I have been noticing that I have to put in more details where I got the bases from and stuff like that. But elsewise, I will just use the my own art, and you can see my art on my Divinian art, so you know how much it actually means to me to try to make you guys happy. And that was actually all for today. Do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and your loved ones. And I hope that you remember that Alicorns also have a place in the community. We have respected Alicorns, and I don't understand why, you know, people are so indifferent and can't see, you know, that we just want to be loved. All OCs needs a place to be, even the bad ones. So yeah, that's actually all that I have to say. Okay, yeah, bye.